The Venda Museum is a museum and archive of the Cold War. It specializes in acquiring, preserving, and providing access to the material record of the Soviet bloc. When we started the wall project, I think we're all pretty excited about it, but also totally cognizant of the fact that there wasn't any kind of blueprint for this. And I think it was that excitement of wanting to be part of something on a larger scale, where there was that same drive to do something that was never done before. So when we started the wall project and we said, listen, this is going to be a project that is not a commemoration or memorial, but engages Los Angeles. And it's about trying to visualize what it would be like if LA were divided between East and West.
With school, you made like a trip to the capital of East Germany, so which was Berlin, and the whole class went for like a couple days, and we traveled around and saw the sights, and that's when I first time saw the Berlin Wall. When you saw it and it hit you, that the other side is there, but you can never go there. As a child, I thought I was okay, and it didn't bother me too much, actually. My girlfriend and I, we took a trip to Eisenach. And Eisenach is also close to the border to West Germany. So there was a lot of construction going on and we got lost. And all of a sudden, we wound up at a roadblock and we were at the West German border. They thought we were trying to escape. They both locked us up and they interrogated us for about 3-4 hours. They constantly repeated, why do you want to escape? Why do you want to escape? And they were just yelling at us. He was screaming at me, why would you escape? Why would you escape? I said, we didn't want to escape. I think they just put me back in my cell and just turned the lights out and let me stay there. They didn't tell me anything. They just locked me up and said nothing. That really was the first confrontation where I felt, oh, you can't get out anytime.
The project itself will focus on two walls. One of those walls will be Wall Along Wilshire. Wall Along Wilshire will be 10 segments of the original Berlin Wall, making it the longest stretch of the Berlin Wall in the world outside of Berlin.
It's amazing to actually see it all come together. I mean, I think I saw it on paper, but to actually see it real life and coming up so high and then coming down right in a row, it's really amazing.
It just gave me the chills when I saw this, when I put up the pieces of the wall. Reminded me of the time when I was growing up in East Germany and then when I saw on TV that the wall came down. So your whole life comes back in your mind, the things you did, the things you couldn't do. This will give people a glimpse of how we lived in East Germany.
I think it's a good event. I mean, I think it's a piece of artwork, you know, plus it's a part of history. I mean, I just remember Ronald Reagan, you know, saying, Gorbachev, tear down this wall. Now here it is, putting it back up. Beautiful Los Angeles.
Longest stretch of the Berlin Wall in the world outside of Berlin.
The wall across Wilshire that's going to go up for one day on November 9th is going to be painted by many artists. We're asking artists to talk about and artistically reflect the wall in our lives. Alongside Terry Noir, who's the original Berlin Wall artist, who started to paint the wall before everybody else did as a sign of political protest.
Something is not right with me! Something is not right with me! Something is not right with me! How was I supposed to know? Something is not right with me! Something is not right with me!
I'm a street artist. I love the opportunity to put my work on walls. Some artists that I really like Keith Haring, had painted the Berlin Wall. So I thought, in the tradition of people painting on the Berlin Wall, for me to get to do something on a replica of the wall for the anniversary would be a really great project.
I went to Korea, and
she's like, half Korean.
I'm half Korean. I thought, well, half Korean,
South Korean, North Korea.
Coming here and seeing this wall, for me to be of Mexican descent, to see any huge wall that's separating any piece of land for people traveling freely, I just had to equate it to like a border.
Something is not right with me. Something is not right with me. I'm trying not to let it show.
I'm gonna paint Kennedy, who 2 years after it went up said, you know, I'm a Berliner, meaning that we're all affected by this idiocy.
As a free man, I take pride in the words, Ich bin ein Berliner.
And then Reagan, who 2 years before I went down, said, Gorbachev, if you want peace, tear down this wall.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
Certain people want to climb them. Certain people want to get over them. Certain people want to paint them. Certain people want to knock them down, you know. And only a few people really want to see them standing.
Let it show.
November 9th. This is the exact 20th anniversary of the fall of the wall. And at that time, the wall across Wilshire will be assembled, pulled together, and stretched across Wilshire Boulevard for 3 hours. During this time, we'll hear speeches, a video presentation from the mayor of Berlin, and at the end of it, our wall will come down too.
It's truly an amazing experience to stand here today. To welcome all of you to this event commemorating the 20th anniversary of the fall of the Berlin Wall.
And as many in this room here tonight can attest, absolutely incomprehensible that this wall project has happened.
I'm very honored to be here tonight and to be able to say I'm free.
The 9th of November 1989. Wir freuen uns, dass Los Angeles durch ein Projekt, ein Mauerprojekt.
This 80-foot brocade barricade behind me is painted by professional artists, street graffiti artists, and the public. It is a canvas that reflects the diversity of discourse in Berlin, and indeed, throughout the entire world, all influenced by the fall of the wall.
It's important to look back, because what you find is something that we've found with the Wall Project, which is that the larger ideas and concepts are not limited to this historical time period. They're very much now, and they're very much in the future. It's about understanding us. It's about understanding humans. That is the basis of history.